The same applies with us. Same thing, but it's not just a thing. news because it's hard to fix things just reading the newspaper. It's hard to fix things just looking at the news. It's hard to fix things sometimes just to hear what one another has to say. It's a phase of materialistic world. Even if those qualities are great, everything is hard, you have a car. If you put the car, what is to happen? Perhaps longer than 2,000, and you're now sitting 16 years later, wait a minute. This is Christmas 1.3 to 1.3. You are depressed and sad, not because you don't have. You have, but you don't have what you want. You just have what you need. So you become depressed. And that's giving you what you need, but perhaps you stop to want what you want from you. It's part of your life. So why am I starting this way? What are we supposed to be talking about this brand of heaven? To me, it means something crucial. And now the Father who has allowed our roots for any excuse to forgive you and to grant you dinner. To grant you power, give him something. Something. When you look at the world of women, it's not just one world. There are eight different worlds. So many different worlds. There are so many different things that will earn you dinner. They will get people to dinner. So now the Father who has allowed mercy to come. Specific single day in a time put you straight into paradise. So you're not sick. That doesn't mean just do one thing. It gives you one example. You know, there's a relation with my friends in a car. Someone entered paradise because of being compassionate towards a female. So because of being compassionate towards the past, they were told, okay, this person was in some of the journey. So I remember meeting someone who told me, you know what, I really have no hope. I don't use Salah, I'm not just talking to you, but I took a lot of cats. I took a lot of cats because I know I'm not allowed to stop. So who was saying that you've misinterpreted the whole thing? I'm not saying Allah doesn't like or allow the cats. No. But the reality is there was compassion. Allah is showing you to be compassionate towards others. Yes, it could lead towards your paradise. Doesn't mean that you need to corrupt the country for, you know, about people's acts, for example. Because there is another relation that you mentioned that a certain man who actually turned with a yellow stuff for his shoe with some water in order to quench the thirst of the dog, and that Jesus will not die for the son of God, and that is one of the things. Because you need to be in your life, your days, the moment you get to display to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your comfort, the end of it. So, there are so many of these things. I'll give you another example. It's so difficult to teach quality, especially for the system, because of what's going on across the globe, because of the environment you may be living in, the pain of things like, because of whatever reason, it's so difficult. So many have contemplated abandoning the Qur'an based on what rule it is. And those who are not connected to Islam are perpetrating in the name of Islam, in terms of violence and killings across the globe or in some parts of the globe, and it has a negative impact on everyone else. So some contemplate abandoning the Qur'an because it's become difficult to match, for example, the public funds for these different countries identifying themselves as a Muslim. For you, your paradise lies in remaining happy and happy for the sake of the country. As difficult as it was, he said, oh Allah, if you need to see about those difficulties, you know that you will never go to compromise something that is connected to your faith. That to me is more important than anything else. Because it's that knowledge that will determine what deed is the same. At the time when it's extremely difficult for you to do something, and you do it for the sake of Allah, that is what the value is all about. For example, Salah. It might be simple for you to use Salah to cover because you work in the midst of this meal and everyone's praying and you just simply talk to Allah. I'll give you this. Now, remember, this is a true story, okay? There was a group of people, a children as well, and what happened is, we were on an outing. We used to look in your brain. So, you know, some of the pictures are distinct from training on certain days. So, someone was asking, one of the sisters was asking, are you coming to train? He says, no, I'm not here. I'm not here. He could have gone to some of the young boys, and they were surprised, I'm not here. What do you mean I'm not here? What happened? They were saying no. What do you mean what happened? They were saying no. It's not just sin or death. Anyway, these kids did not know what to tell you of the kind of rulers. I don't even know some of them. I don't even think some of them might have known what actually happens to do this. I'm not talking about that. Just for our sisters and their pieces and whatever or not, as he goes to come to them, whatever they go to, and the same applies to the maids, whatever or not, we're talking about the time of the chosen cross, we are pure, and we are not some people of Allah, we have some lesson to talk about the time of the maids and the maids. So, when it's difficult for you to do something, you do it. For the glory of Allah, that deed has to be created up. Remember, we have just got because of all the stress of the world, and all the worries and thoughts, you've been away most of the night. And you call up the first time to touch on your eyes, Moses. And that's why you're starting off. You didn't care, and then you are alarmed, peace. But now it knows, and you get up, and you sit up as much as you know, you look at that scene, as much as you know, it came after such a great effort, but you look sure, you realize and understand. You look back to the fact that your prayer comes before your sleep. Then you know, I like to follow him when he was in, if you're actually now going to see me. The message Allah has asked us here in the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to call people to that prayer in the morning, saying, as Salah to follow him in the morning, indeed the prayer is written. So if you do that, you surely will earn the praise of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. But what is the sister's factor? Like I said, everyone's going through difficulties, not because Allah wants to make your life difficult, but because Allah wants to give you opportunities to get closer to Him. You can help you. You have a illness, you have a sickness, you may have arthritis, you may have just been, for example, diagnosed with something, you may be a person who doesn't have children, you may be a person who doesn't have male or female children, depending, you may be a person who's going through some medical crisis, some financial issues. It's not because Allah wants to put you through a problem, it's because Allah wants you to become closer to Him and to use these issues to earn your goodness, He will give it to you. If you are patient, by the will of Allah, you will get that power. So many different ways of entering Jannah, so many different views that please Allah to come over time. Not just one thing. Someone will enter Jannah because of how much Allah gave them love and the music. Someone will enter Jannah because Allah gave them the expertise to use it. Someone will enter Jannah because Allah to come over time and listen with faith and reason. Someone will enter Jannah because perhaps Allah put them somewhere at a place where or the time when there was a need for them and they helped them. Look at the flaws that are happening across the buildings in mind, and then the psychological and so on, those who are there, and they are able and capable to help, and they are helped and leading from the house of us, if they are able and capable to reach out to those who need, and you have reached out at that moment, Allah is watching. He knows it would be wrong to do, you would be swimming perfectly well. Who is perhaps a very sick person who knows how to die. And at the same time, people are drowning and they're just thinking, you know, like what they do nowadays. Someone drowning and they go, and they take out their camera and they say, one minute, funny. And they take video on all the photos. And someone says, wait, wait, don't go and help them right now. One more. If you wrote the word one more, and they put in pictures, one more. How can you do that? You need to know when to take the photograph and when not to take it. People today are so obsessed that when there is a dire, desperate need of need to rush to the assistance of a person who is dying, you're more interested in taking the picture, documenting the film. You always have our time of produce, our obsessions with technology. The test view is the best of you. Every one of us can do better when it comes to technology. Every one of us. This is the world's statement that is applicable to God. Ourself and the Lord, Allah, grant me goodness to make us know from among those whom goodness is granted to. So, there are so many narrations that make mention of these things that are not found. This evening, we want to talk about a group of people that I usually refer to as VIPs. And this is our language. VIP means a very important person. Imagine, again, someone from the crowd is sitting there. Just if he wants to get to the fact that suddenly your name is called out from here. Think about it for a minute. You need to do it. You get a call sitting in the back. You need a bit of a voice here. So the fact that you're going to do it. But anyway, you do it. These young men, brothers who are sitting right here, I'm sure they were at the back now thinking to themselves, you know what, let's go. It's terrible. Oh, to be honest, we'll go right to the front. It doesn't mean from me. The boys are coming in to help us. And some of the stuff is said earlier, I was looking in the middle of God's right. I want to give you an example. The Lord really was filled out the day you need to say it right, as I entered the source of brothers and sisters. So I didn't know what to say. That's the power of work as well. We put them at work. And I think to myself, you are not down to such a cycle from the world yet. This is the true excitement. The excitement in this world is definitely not. What is the true happiness? What is the true competition? It's to get to the best. It's to be in general. And then, when we are given our gifts in the right hand, that's the way we are super excited. In order to get it well, we need to work in this world in a way that whatever challenges all of us in our lives, you won't know what that is. You won't even know why. Because we are praying. Because we believe this. We are praying. The creation of PIP is very important to us. The reason your name is called on the Day of Judgment is because so low, people are sitting, so are suffering, people are worried, worried about themselves, their peace, the day of exposure, the day when all of these may be worried, come and help us. Remember, if you don't want your peace to be made, then it is a way out. And now, right before such that even the angels don't know what's going on. That's why I start to go to the right message. And I must have my kind of clarity. And you repent, you do good things, you will convert the bad news back into good. So, Father, not for the stories of the day of judgment, it's a lie. The lamentation of the punishment of those who commit sin, and then he says, in exception goes, where is it? Repent and do good deeds thereafter. If you repent, the Bible is right. If you repent and do good deeds thereafter and your life is changed, then the Bible comes back in a different form. First of all, it comes onto the scale of good deeds because you have forsaken it for the first of all. The person committing adultery, victory, and then continue committing the sin one after the other, and it becomes a habit. You are piling up that evil, isn't it? The things are being piled up. And there comes a day when you say, oh Allah, forgive me for your sin. Forgive me. I admit, I regret, I repent, and I won't do it again. If I replace that with good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in this particular verse, you will regret the evil that the people have done in the past. Those people who have repented and followed up with good deeds thereafter, you will replace that with good on the right side of the story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to give up the sins that we've been committing to say, Allah, we all sin differently, some major, some minor. Let's try to have a little bit of pain. Let's try and go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We call ourselves Muslimin. We want to see solutions to the problems that we're facing across the globe. The best way is to start us with ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped us do that. So, imagine on that day when it's the day of exposure, everything is going to come to the fore. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is an announcement being made saying, so and so. There is a special place for you to be. Suddenly it's working. You're new. And it's specific. The next best thing that happens is you're so excited going to this place that Allah has chosen for you, and you're so proud of the fact that what you're doing on earth really has helped. That's the day you're allowed to be proud. Your pride is prohibited in this world. When I say pride here, I'm talking about your pride. I'm not talking about yourself, I'm proud to be a Muslim. They're not connected to be a Muslim. They're proud means they're happy. So if you say I'm proud to be a Muslim, it means I'm happy to be a Muslim. I don't need to hide the fact that I'm a Muslim. You say I'm a proud Muslim. It doesn't mean I'm an arrogant Muslim. Because the two do not go hand in hand. The two are opposite poles. Pride and Islam, they don't really come together.
Thank you. So many other things, you know,
we haven't even looked at that. Well, it's 14. 14 is going to be for the teenagers. That's what they call it.
Reading that.
Thank you.
allows for the pleasure of Allah to study the Quran. When you see people trying to obey Allah's instruction one way or another, can that make you feel the connection? So I'm walking in the streets of London, for example, and I see a sister dressed like a proper Christian woman. I said, oh, where are you? And I see her dark sister there, little kids in the shoulder of the corner. But I know how difficult it is to dress that way, and I will never know who she was. And in my mind, I feel she's like Allah. I feel the they will never know me, I will never know them. What's connecting me to them? The fact that she's trying to please Allah. She's doing something to please Allah. No, I'm not helping. No, I'm not helping. No, I'm not helping. It's the fact that it's a fair goal to the public place. It's been something almost in that you're loving. You're looking to the public. Now, if it is a person of the opposite sex, you do not have to tell them. Yes, you know what I'm not using the person of Allah. But if it's a person of the same sex, it's a thing that you're looking to tell them. And I recall these people who happened a lot of the time. When you have been to see a car, it's not good. So the blessing of Allah. It's not like a password for the pleasure of Allah. Does that make the first part of it halal? No. Yes. It's easy. You can just make your husband. Who knows if you call for the pleasure of Allah? If you love them, there's nothing wrong with loving your sister and yourself for the pleasure of Allah. But there's something wrong in what you do. If it only is for the pleasure of Allah, you know its limits, you know its mind. You know what to do, you know what to say, you know who to say, you know if you have to say it, why to say it. So, I remember I told this one couple, he said, no, so, what is it that you're going to do? Let's talk to this. So, you know, we were studying together, saying, yeah, oh, so you know, it's just to do something. That's going around, you were tired, 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 make it halal! It will continue love for the pleasure of Allah. You can love your family members for the pleasure of Allah. But Allah has given you a different type of love when it comes to your father and mother. I can love my father for the pleasure of Allah. So I can dislike him for the pleasure of Allah. But I have a different type of a love, a filial love, for example. I have a different type of a love and a connection that is there. That would not make him true. He's right, even if he was not a Muslim. Think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, when it comes to others, you love them for the pleasure of Allah, that's it, subhanAllah. However, you happen to now be business with the person, you happen to now be so much more, because no problem. You still love them for the pleasure of Allah. And you will still guide them, you will still help them, you don't guide them, you will take the guidance, and then you love someone for the sake of Allah. And they correct you, you take the correction, because you know, hey, this person told me what's right and wrong, and I need to, this is for the sake of Allah. And when they tell you something, the father of Allah, the other way around, if you were to tell them something, they should be ready to tell you. The father of Allah. So, let's understand. When you see someone, for example, in the masjid, in the house of Allah, the father of Allah, the other way around, and you see him all time in one corner, reading Salah, he's trying to do this to you. Don't tell yourself this man is boasting, he's arrogant, he's showing up, this lady, for example, started running with his cigar, the joint, he just wants to show up. No! Have a good thought. But look, this person is trying to obey Allah, so I love him. I mean, I'm sure I was in that position where I could also reach Allah in such a way. At this age, when I am so old like him, I got Allah, may Allah grant me the ability to do that. It encourages us, it motivates us to do good. That's what is the benefit of love in Allah is, it will motivate us and help us collectively to do good and encourage us to look in the right direction. This is why it is so important. Like I said, when a person is going to put something good in return for a deed, that deed is something serious. It's not just a minor thing. It has some broad, great benefit. You know, for the sake of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine what it was. And you speak to your colleagues about Allah, about Islam. And they're so you won't feel your level of power. And guess what? When you start thinking to feel more powerful than them, that's where the problem is. I always say, if someone thinks they're older than you, we're not talking about power, we're talking about goals. We're not talking about goals. You have goals in your heart, you have goals in your mind, you have goals for a moment. You must have a goal, you must have a goal. Let's move on. So we spoke about those two who love each other for the sake of another, the pleasure of another, but brought you together with love. All for the God of intended with you, the goal of it, the unity that becomes strong because of Allah. This person is doing good. This person is the ones of Allah. This person is trying. This person has truth. This person is trying to read Allah. I don't care for it. I'm not doing for the sake of Allah. I'm standing in it. Beautiful. Then, what is the reason? It is extremely important that what I love about this hadith is straight to the point. No evidence, no candy coating, no icing. The hadith of Rabbul Ulum Baqat Ulum Ra'at 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 Ulum and she had a place to stay with her. Everything was there. The summer place, there was no way. Like, there was an obstacle between the two. Except the consciousness of Allah. So the man said, just here, I will do this. And the same applies in the other way. If a man happens to draw a woman, he commits the same sin. And it's all the same person. And the man is a good man. He's a tough person. For example, he's a good looking guy as well. Everything he tells is full of becoming secret. Nobody's going to know. The only thing is, I feel like I have a reason to drop it. I feel like he's so direct. Can you believe? So direct. Imagine if this is the status of a person who claimed the government habit. Only for the sake of Allah. What do you think is the crime of a person who makes such a thing? On the globe at the moment, how much have we heard of women being abused? They are told, you know what, you have a problem with something, whether it's your family, whether it's your something else, your work, your job is at stake. But you know what? If you do me a sexual favor, I'm going to get you. Excuse yourself. You take the first time you can work on a doctor. How do you know why you can do it? You might have lost your job, you might have lost your status, you might have had your permit, your health, you might have had everything. Allah has done nothing. That was your one ticket to the world. But I'm quite sure this problem is becoming more and more common because we are living in a thin barrel in a piece of world at the moment. It is becoming more and more thin barrel in a piece of I think I tell you that I think that to the point, it is very correct. It is, you know, it's a real truth. What is this? It's just true. There is the according to words. What will you pick from a moment of this? This feminine, a female, or the other way around. This thing speaks about a man saying no. Some of them ask why. Why didn't the hadith say the woman saying no? I tell you why. Women will tell them, in fact, for a man when everything is facilitated. It becomes difficult to say no. People know women will probably hold back. For men, we say this is my love. This is all facilitated. You need more power to say no. As a woman, the woman by nature, she wouldn't move into this kind of inner world so quickly. The man, you and I know. That's why the woman says, isn't it? You know, they look at you, they keep on looking at you, they keep on looking at you. And then you start looking at the ground. They keep on looking at you. And then you start looking at them from the other side. The moment they start looking at you, it's still the first look. How are they doing? Number one, if you're doing well. Number two, if you're embarrassing the people. Number three, if you want 10% more religious capital, you can do it with what you now. Thank you a lot. You know, I was in Nigeria 2 days ago, and you talked to one of the economists, and one of them, the local Nigerian folks, who was speaking about how when something comes in your street, those who are on your phone, or at the people who happen to be part, you know, you have a new name, you have someone who's supposed to be looking at. So what are you supposed to do? You still put the phone in front of you. Which means, you can, how did you know this stuff? Because you look at it for the whole world, you think you? is about that so many Muslims come into my business now that they know what I do. This is a disgrace. It's embarrassing, you know? You know what? We still get to know each other, but don't just look at your own benefit. I'm good. I ask about everyone to come to you. This is all. All that same thing is yours. Not a lot, but. They won't come next time because they're going to think of it right, you know? I'm sure there are really important people sitting in our society. I'm convinced of it, even among the sisters. I'm convinced there are really important people sitting around. You know, all right, what is it? But that's some people who have run out of their way to be here. Get money for it. They're not good for you. They're not going to the best of this world and the next. This is what makes the owner. People don't know what you've done in order to be here for the time. So tell me what. This is why we say, when you do, when you do, you don't have to brag about it. Tell me. There is someone who did something for me. For me. And every time he reminds me, he says, you know what? Don't forget, you know what, brother? I can't believe what I do. Give me just about going to your people. To be honest, you don't get out of it. You took that amount of data to your charity. I told you, this is what amount I'm giving to your charity. I'm telling you about my own activity. And I didn't even listen because I didn't get it. You want to do something to someone, please, for the sake of Allah, not to do. You know, the God of for the rest of your life, you know, remember, you go to do the thing, remember that. You can take him. So, you know, yes, I want to comment. That's what you want to do. Thank you. Some of us don't even
Thank you.